a note on the nature of acoustic space. I've spent some time recently out of doors concentrating on trying to understand what the essential nature of the acoustic world is. Sitting in the park with the children on Good Friday, Holy Saturday, I hear the footsteps of people walking past me on the footpath. Many different kinds of footsteps. Women's high-heeled shoes. Shoes that sound like flip-flops. Groups of people walking together or apart. Children toddling along with rapid steps. Somebody running. They come from this side and that side. They mingle and separate and pass me. There's the rustling of the newspaper from somebody sitting on the next bench. And the murmur of conversation from people sitting on the same bench. Further out to the right and behind me, there's the car park and the sound of people starting and stopping their cars and driving off. Way off to the left, there's the main road and the noise of the heavy traffic roaring past in the distance. Further in front of me is the lake with the ducks and the other pond birds, with all the quacking and the splashing that goes on all the time as they land and take off and fight and squabble over bits of food. There's the splash splash of the paddle boat, and the little children crying out. Further off, there's the different sound of the rowing boats out on the larger lake. Beyond that is the park itself, and here one has the distant cries of people playing ball, shouts of children. This is all set against the breeze blowing in the trees behind me, and the myriad voices and sounds coming from all these directions create a panorama of music and information, which is absorbing and fascinating. I suddenly hear a voice from the lake. My children are there. Previously they were not there. Not until they cried out. The strange thing about it is that it's a world which consists only of activity. Every sound is a point of activity. Where there is no activity, there's no sound. And then that part of the world dies.